What's up, guys, and welcome to You Can, the show that equips you with the knowledge to customize your vehicle. I'm your host, Annie. You don't need to be a pro to handle basic installations. Kick your feet up, unwind, and enjoy another episode of Heise TV. This is a two-part installation to keep the show from getting too long. Please join us for part one as we kick off the installation with Brandon, our product specialist.
So today we'll be installing the HE-SWP8 8 gang switch panel on our Jeep Wrangler JL project vehicle. This is a universal part that is a great command center for all your aftermarket accessories. This kit comes with quite a bit, so let's have a look at what's included.
With a difficulty level of 2 out of 3, today's install may require more know-how and tools that are not included in a standard toolkit.
Off the bat, we have the switch panel. This is where the driver will be turning on and off the accessories by pressing one of the 8 buttons. There's a sheet of 50 stickers so you can label the buttons accordingly to what is connected. The text along with the images make identification really easy. Next, we have 2 mounting bracket options. If you want a flush mount switch panel, Heise offers the HE-SWP8C, which is sold separately. Moving on, we have the controller cable to connect the switch panel to the controller box. This controller box is where your accessories like lights and controllers will be connected. Inside the controller box, you can see that the 8 connections are independently fused. The 3-pin header is for the status cable, which activates the switch panel's backlight and powers up the system when the car is turned off. The large terminals are for connecting the controller box to the vehicle's battery, and this is done with the included power cables and circuit breaker. The final part in this box is a universal bracket to help you mount the control box in the vehicle. Before we start this install, I'm gonna be sending you on over to Aaron for tool time to look at some of the tools we'll be needing today.
All right, Jeepers, we're gonna go over the tools needed to mount the universal HE-SWP8 switch. We've got it kind of arranged into an interior group and an exterior group. Looks like a lot, but if you break it down by step, it's not really. For mounting the control panel, you're gonna need a drill with the 1/8-inch drill bit. It goes in with 2 Phillips screws. You're gonna need a panel pry tool for popping out panels so you can run wire. We do recommend a silver marker. That way you can mark your holes before you screw them. Throughout the entirety of the build, you'll need a 10-millimeter socket, wrench, and extension in various places. General housekeeping items. It'll be good if you have a Dremel, but the area that this would come in handy, you can use a file, could use a box knife style, anything like that. So for your heat shrink, you can use a lighter, heat gun, hairdryer, whatever you have available. Need a couple lengths of wire. We recommend about 10 to 12 inches. Some barrel connectors. Green masking tape or any kind of masking tape to protect your paint while you're fitting everything up. And we have our wire strippers and crimpers. These do come together in some applications where you buy them, but whatever you have, that'll work just fine. And your handy dandy instructions, and that's all you need. So what I'm gonna do is throw it to our safety man, John.
Thanks, Aaron. All right, guys, like Aaron said, safety is important for you and safety is important for the vehicle. So to get ready today, we're gonna go to our toolbox, get a drawer so we can store our personal items. Things like watches and rings are dangerous for you. Wife might not like it, but hey, I like my fingers. So to finish that off, we're gonna put on our safety glasses. Now that we're ready, let's get going.
True story, John. So what we're gonna do to make our install easier today is take the top off. Now this particular Jeep has a fabric top, so slightly different operation than if you have the Freedom top. But to get the soft top off, all you have to do is push these levers down and release. And then this one's really new. It's got 300 miles on it, so the tops are a little stiff. So having a buddy help you pop this up evenly is gonna make that easier for you. then that's going to let us do our install here for our switch panel. So we're going to start the installation today by the switch panel bracket. On this Jeep, we're going to mount it here on your sail panel. Easiest way to do this, line it up with the passenger airbag light and just center it. We're going to be using a silver permanent marker to mark our holes out. And that'll give you a nice guide on what to actually drill. So now we have our holes marked. You want to drill straight in at a probably 90 degree angle. Don't drill this way, don't drill this way. Straight in, nice and slow. That way we don't hit this metal behind it and we don't hit the module for the passenger air support light. So guys, just so you know, this is a curve. So, you know, don't beat yourself up. If you want, you can put masking tape there to keep it from walking, but little pressure, nice and slow. All right, so before we mount the bracket, you can note that this has an orientation to it, right? You can mount it up if you prefer. For our installation, we're gonna mount it down. So it sits a little bit lower. So in the included hardware, you got these little guys. And what I wanna do is I'm gonna walk it over to the panel. Again, nice and slow. Just get it started. Don't cinch it down. And get your drill ready. Again, nice and slow. And you just want to cinch these down till they're taut. So just plastic you're going into. Now this will stay nice and secure because we only used an 1/8-inch drill bit to do it. But if you put too much torque from your drill through it, you will strip out the plastic and end up having to find another way to install it. Kind of off screen on our bench, we put the other side of the bracket onto the switch panel. With this switch panel, you're going to want these indicator lights on the downside of it. So included with your kit, you're going to get, like I said earlier, the Allen key. And these are just going to line up into those holes like so. So using Allen's key, we're going to run it right in. And at this point, don't be overly concerned where your wire is hanging because we're going to take care of that in the next step. So once that's kind of secure, we're going to jump to the other side here. And you can cinch this down and just kind of get a relative idea of where you want it to sit. Because you can always change it when you put your top down if you don't like it. Okay, that's done. That's in, looks great, it's not going anywhere. Now for this, we're going to put the part number below. This is a Heise LED extension. The amazing thing about it is we're going to use it with our switch pod to extend our wiring through the firewall. So what you want to find is your end. We're just going to fish it through the top here. And you'll find a couple of reliefs on each side of this panel where we've mounted it. We're going to go in through this, but to get to it, you're gonna need to drop this panel just a little bit. And the easiest way to do that is if you pull this out here, and it doesn't take much, just a little pressure down. Because all we're trying to do is pass this cable from the front, or you know, closest to us, to the front of the Jeep. So we're gonna pull our cord through. And at this point, you just wanna kinda keep it as neat as you can without bunching it up, because that's gonna help you pull it through the A pillar in the next steps. All right, so right there, and then we're gonna want to go ahead and re-secure this panel. So there are some copper clips here, copper colored clips, if you will. You want to reposition those to be into their slot. And you might have to lift yourself up for this step so you can see them. But it's just a situation where you're taking the plastic and clipping it back in like that. So our next order of operation is gonna be getting it through the rest of the sail panel into your A-pillar. So quick little pro tip, we're gonna take one of our zip ties, just to dress this out a little bit, using one of the exact same holes we mounted the panel with, just to secure it down. And that's just gonna keep that wire from wiggling around on you. Snip it off flush. And then because we didn't zip it down to its fullest tie, you can twist this around. And as you can see, it gives a nice path from the panel back to our gap that we're using for our wire. Just a quick little pro tip. So what we're gonna do is take it from the sail panel through the A-pillar into the dash, and that's gonna get us to the grommet where we need to transition through the firewall to the engine bay. What we're gonna do to do that is, using our panel pry tool, we're gonna pop these caps off of the A-pillar, which is harder to do with the pry panel than your fingernail. And using our 10 mil, you're gonna get in here. It's kind of a weird angle, but you'll see them. Just loosen these up. Now there is a stay inside of here, so don't expect this bolt to come flying out at you. It will remain in place. All right, and you'll hear when the screw comes off because it'll be hopping inside of the thread. So now that we got it loosened up, what we're gonna do is just pull this wire through our sail panel. And there's a transition up top. So we're gonna continue this, again, just fishing it through this pillar. There's no reason to pull the whole thing off. Fish it through the pillar. Underneath, just pull it back lightly with your hand. All right, so now what we're gonna do is re-secure the A-pillar handle grab bar to the vehicle. All right, and then just all you have to do is re-secure these covers, and the tweeter popped off while we were routing that, and that part is done. So we're gonna have to reposition our camera so we can show you the dashboard to the grommet. All right, so we're gonna pop this dash panel off, and to do that, you'll see a seam around here and the seam to the door. Just find your widest gap, get your panel tool behind there, Now what we're gonna do is, you can see the dashboard substructure. We're going to try to avoid that while getting down into this cavity right here, just after the substructure. And you'll see, as you're looking at it, or maybe my glasses will pick it up, where we're trying to go here. So we're gonna reach up under our dash here and just fish this wire over to ourselves. Pull it out the bottom. And once you've completed that, this is done. We can put the panel back on. And the easiest way to do that is, has this kick out, tuck it in, and then roll it into place. So the next step in our install is going to be to get the cable through the firewall. This is kind of a two-person moment, because on these Jeeps, it's a hard plastic piece. It's easier to push it from the backside, so meaning the interior. So for this, I'm gonna call my buddy John real quick.
Hey, hey!
We're gonna tag team it, and get that cable through so it's under the engine bay. Push that through till your buddy grabs it. All right, so this is the grommet that we took out. As you can see, it's kind of got a molded rubber on it, but it's hard plastic. So to pass that 9/32 inch piece through, we're going to drill that out. Recommend using a vise for this. That way you're not holding it. So if the grill bit does grab on, it doesn't hurt you. All right, and just to clean anything up, you can flip it over since we're using a Christmas tree bit. Or a stepper bit, as some call it. Gonna install that in the Jeep and then pass the cable through. So with my buddy here, we're going to pop this back in the firewall, it clips in, then I'm gonna pass the cable through to him. Kind of a two-man operation, two-person operation, just to get that through. So here you go, John, pop that through for me. And then the next thing you'll see is the cable coming out at you. All right, and the end is through. And as he's pulling that, make sure you don't have any kinks in your cable. And there you go. You want to push this away from the substructure and out the firewall.
Stay tuned for the next episode where we will be finishing this install. Remember, you can with Heise. If you like the show, subscribe, smash that like button, ring that notification bell so you never miss a moment with Heise TV. We'll see you soon in the next one.